Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the civil services examination, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our mains answer writing series. So friends, as some of you might be knowing that we have a daily mains answer writing series, in which what we do, we daily give you 5 questions of which you have to write the answers. So some students were demanding case you provide the questions, but please also provide the model answers of these questions so that we can get an idea that how to approach a particular question. So upon that request, we decided that we will be discussing daily one question from the perspective of guiding you in writing better answers. Because why only one is chosen? Because 5 questions will take lot of time, so that's why we have decided to focus upon one question only. So today's question is: integration into global supply chains is essential if India is to become a $5 trillion economy. Comment. So friends, recently the economic survey as well as the Prime Minister of India announced that India is targeting to be a $5 trillion economy. So here multiple articles are coming in newspapers how India can transform itself into a $5 trillion economy. So in that context, this question is asked, and it is about global supply chains. So before starting, let me tell you friends that this is not a model answer. You can take it only as a reference source. Why we are saying that it is not a model answer? Because no answer in UPSC can be a model answer. Because had that been the case, the students would have the toppers would have scored 100% marks. So you can need not consider any answer as model answer. Each answer has its own strengths and weaknesses. So let's start our discussion. So you can start by introducing that what this global supply chain means. So first of all, you can think upon what is global supply chain. So then you can write about how it can help India. So India has to tackle multiple fronts, the challenges on multiple fronts, but one of them is exports. So there are multiple things that due to which exports are continuing to underperform, and government must step up them. So lackluster export growth is there, then there is weak domestic demand, and there is subdued investment activity. So all indicates that primary drivers of growth are not good. So also in this context, why India should be more concerned about global supply chains? Because currently China it is expected that Chinese exports will become costly because of the rising wages. So India can reap the benefit by improving its competitiveness, because obviously the cheap labor is available in India, so our products can be more competitive in terms of pricing. And also then we have to focus upon ease of doing business instead of infrastructure to benefit from trade and be better integrated into the value chain. So basically global supply chains comprise of two things, that is forward linkage and backward linkages. So global supply chain it is a thing in which complex goods are produced in multiple countries and they are assembled in different countries. So when industries of exporting country provide inputs into exports of industries in the importing country, it is called forward linkage. Say for example, if a country imports from B country, and B country just exports its raw material, and that raw material is processed by the country A to make further goods that can be exported by it, then it is called forward linkage. And when backward linkage is that when a particular product is imported by a country to manufacture further goods which it can export, then it is called backward linkage. So in simple terms, if there are two countries, that is A and B, and if B exports to the country A then intermediary goods, then country B is linked with forward linkage. Country A is linked with forward linkage, and country B is linked with backward linkage. So India also has its own strengths and weaknesses weaknesses. So if we come to strengths, then there is a vast pool of engineers and there is competitive labor force, and also there is familiarity with English and other things are also there which can help India to reap the benefit of global supply chains. So there are many MNCs that have set up design and R&D centers in the country that are connected with manufacturing sectors. So with right policy environment, a thriving industrial sector well integrated with shifting regional supply chains could help boost exports as well as create new jobs. So how India can integrate into global supply chain? So we can adopt the approach of moving gradually from low value products to high value products. So as of now, India exports mainly low value products. So it is and also it is one of the primary drivers of growth. In fact, the growth which was seen in the mid 2000 in the midst of first decade of 21st century, it was basically due to higher exports. So these exports must be focused upon, and India must also facilitate that Indian market is integrated with global market by the reduction of tariffs and by rationalization of tariffs, so that important goods that are of importance or relevance for manufacturing further finished goods can be imported with low cost, so that the manufacturing sector can grow. Indian manufacturing sector can grow. And then also there is global trade segment as of now. So there are there are trade wars that are going between US and Iran, not US and Iran, but US and China. And then there is also protectionism that is growing. So here it shows that the global trade is becoming stagnant, and also World Trade Organization is not able to prevent this situation from emerging. So this situation is emerging. So in this scenario, if we want us to integrate into global supply chains, then we must focus upon the bilateral preferential trade agreements or regional preferential trade agreements. And then India must also be clear about dovetailing tariff openness with its Make in India program. So it is not just that we have to just reduce our tariffs. So we must reduce in a way that the companies in manufacturing in India, they are able to import raw material or unfinished goods, and then they are unfinished goods at low rate, and then they are able to manufacture finished goods which can be exported further. So there must be focus upon this. That is, tariff openness should be keeping in mind the Make in India program, so that it doesn't harm Indian industry. And then also key lies in driving growth through productivity innovation, because low cost labor alone cannot achieve results. So for example, if there India has low cost labor and competitive labor, but its labor is not that much productive and that much innovative, then India will continue to supply goods that will be of low quality, and India will be integrated into global supply chains with only low value products. So obviously the problem with such low value products is that the emerging economies, for example Bangladesh and Vietnam, like countries like Vietnam, Cambodia, and all these countries are emerging as major supplier of such things which India is already exporting. So if India is already exporting these things, and these countries like Bangladesh and others are coming with competitive products, then India's interest can be harmed. So India must focus upon also the productivity and innovation of its labor, so that India can move further up the ladder of global supply chains. So it must ensure that the better value addition takes place with deeper local supply chains. And also India can begin with lower level initially, but it must not be just contained to that lower level. The level must be encouraged slowly and gradually to move up the ladder of high value products. So it can help country rise within global value chains. Initial integration is however critical. So if India fails to move up the value chain, as I have told you, then the products on the lower end of the value chain could be taken up by the other emerging economies. For example, Bangladesh is also is emerging as a major supplier of textiles and competitive textile products. So that was the co core area of India a few decades back, but now Bangladesh is emerging and Bangladesh is replacing India in terms of this industry. So it is necessary that we must move up the value chain. So we cannot join global value chains unless we have the technology and manufacturing ability, because obviously global market is competitive. If we are exporting something, if we are selling some product in global market, then it must be competitive also, and it must the countries we can say countries industry leaders or manufacturing industry leaders, they must be capable of developing the, those products and that level of technology, so that India can be integrated into global value chain. So obviously that demands increase in the skill and technology levels of the country. So how can the skill be increased? By providing education to the labor force and by providing appropriate ecosystem. And how the technology can be improved? It can be improved by investing in research and development. So today complex goods are already there, such as automobiles or aeroplanes and then computers. They are made of inputs that are produced in various countries, so which are finally assembled in yet another country. So India is also in similar vein, needs to be integrated in those chains and produce specific and specialized products in which it can do better. And let's look at that various options that are before India, which can be explored for integration into global supply chains. So India is part of already, as you know, that global chains in terms of auto components and generic formulations. And then India's pharmaceutical industry also enjoys great demand in developing and emerging markets. So it is also linked with global value chain, and further potential can be harnessed by improving the quality of the medicines and competitiveness of our medicines. And then there must also be a closer look at data that reveals that there are various labor intensive sectors, for example textiles and gems and jewelry, leather. So exports are not moving up in these sectors. They continue to underperform. So these sectors that are labor intensive, for example leather, textile, gems and jewelry, the weaknesses must be looked into and they must be addressed. So there must be gradual integration into global supply chains. And also as of now, India's commerce is involves export of raw materials and low value added goods. So it is not that sufficiently integrated into global supply chains. So these areas must be explored so that we move up the ladder of that value chain. And also there is an agriculture export policy. It must be framed in a manner that farmers are integrated into global supply chains and can raise their income, and India can then attain the goal of doubling farmers' income by 2022. And then there is also issue of defense industry. So India is the fifth largest financer of defense industry. That is, its defense budget is the fifth largest in the world, but it is also the second largest importer of defense equipment. So in this context, focus must be on the indigenization of technology and product producing such products that are in demand in global markets. So assessment, or there must be proper assessment, defense indigenization should take place, and that can happen only through financing for capital, defense capital expenditure. And there must also be assessment of cost, technology transfer capabilities and export potential early in procurement processes. So in most of the agreements, technology transfer doesn't take place, or if it takes place, it takes a lot of time, and when it happens, there is no need of such product in the global market. So there must be when we enter the defense agreements, then there must also be focus upon transferring the technology in a way that there is export potential in the beginning itself, in the procurement process itself, early in the procurement process. And there must also be fair competition between Indian private and public sector, so that Indian private sector can emerge as a major defense manufacturer. For example, if America has companies like Boeing and all those companies, they manufacture high quality, high end technology defense equipments. So there must be proper competition so that Indian private sector can also participate in them and then can sell its product abroad. And then there must also be a thing that that is also highlighted by recent economic survey, that the heart of global supply chain is in basically Southeast Asia, and India plays only a small role in that. So integration of India with these Southeast Asian nations like Cambodia, Myanmar, Laos and your Vietnam can help, and ongoing regional comprehensive trade partnership negotiations can help India integrate into global supply chains. And then value chain development in medical surgical instruments is another potential area, because India imports these medical surgical instruments from abroad at high cost, but in Pakistan these in industries based in Sialkot there are various companies that manufacture these medical surgical instruments. So India can better integrate with Pakistan by supplying steel and all those products to these companies, and then can import low cost medical instruments from Pakistan, which will help India in a kind of reducing its cost over medical surgical instruments which it now imports from Western countries. So there could be integration with Pakistan as well, so that large medical market which India has can be harnessed by Pakistan, as well as India exports steel and other things to these to the Pakistan, so that there is more integration and there is lesser chance of any conflict if the situation arises, because more integration, trade integration means lesser the possibility of such conflict, because otherwise it would harm both the countries. And then there must also be focus upon the electronics value chain, because the electronics are also today in kind of the great demand. So demand is not stopping, but India's role in these electronics is not that much. So focus must be on such things so that the tariffs can be reduced, so that such products and such raw material can be imported, which could be used in the manufacturing of further electronic products which can be exported. So currently the trade deficit in electronics has increased from $27 billion to $42 billion in just 6 years. So this shows that India's high substantial trade deficit in electronics, and also though phased manufacturing program was introduced by Government of India in 2017 so that to curb the imports that were coming under this category, but India must also build its electronic exports. So this is also a way of doing this is to effectively participate in global value chains where Asia has emerged as a major player. And then let's see what are the challenges. So what are the challenges for India's integration into global supply chains? So first of all, there is slowing global trade, that is stagnant global trade, and then also there are ongoing trade wars, for example between USA and China, and there is growing protectionism in the West. And then focus is also that India cannot compromise its interests in agriculture industry and intellectual property rights. So for example, regional comprehensive economic partnership, in that particular proposal there is a threat to there are issues relating to intellectual property rights. So India can't compromise it. And then there is issue of logistics. So currently India's logistics sector is not that much robust, and the data shows that the export competitiveness of a country and its logistics have a direct relation with each other. So there is a direct link between competitiveness of exports and logistics, and India must work on these on this logistics sector. So also India's vulnerability is due to commodity based exports that are raw material based exports, so which does not contribute to global value chains, and also they are highly susceptible to price sensitivity, which in result affects the country's various livelihoods. So India must move up the value chain ladder, so that the products that are not manufactured much, they will be less prone to such price sensitivity, and India will be able to benefit the will be able to reach have the benefits of global value chain. And also there is increasing competition in its core export segments such as textile and agri-based products, as I have told you earlier. Then there is not just cost issue and competitiveness issue, then there is also product compliance issue in these sectors. So India, unless and until India doesn't move in up the value chain, India will continue to face competition from the newly emerging market, newly emerging countries. So it is losing its strong areas which must be addressed. And then also there are concerns over overseas product project implementation, though it has been increasing as of now. So what is the way forward? Way forward is basically to address the above challenges, and for better integration focus must be on various things like for example, there must be proper export import policy so that strategization can be can take place and import only those imports, the imports which are valuable for further further use in the manufacture of further value added products, that those products, those imports must be imported duty free or either with reduced duties. So that as imports of certain products remain essential. For example, recently India exempted 35 machine parts used for manufacturing mobile phone components. So that can help in pushing the Indian electronics, we can say, sector, so that India can get, reap the benefit of global demand. And from thus, basic the basic duty, custom duty was reduced to promote local handset production. And also there must be also balance that must be maintained on import duty structures of various products as strategic level. So at strategic level, so also then India needs to continue to focus upon easing the way business is done. So ease of doing business includes various things, for example, streamlining our tax procedures, and then reducing compliance costs, and also then if there is inter-border trade, then the care must be taken, it must be ensured that the time and the cost associated with border compliance and documentary compliance it is reduced. And also there must be dedicated industrial parks which could help develop a supportive trade ecosystem. And also then backward linkages with MNCs is very important, and domestic industry are critical. So if backward MNCs are producing various things, then domestic industry must be providing to these industries valuable input so that India can gain from these backward linkages and forward linkages. And also focus must be on high quality and on timely delivery. So in this comes the you are reducing time and compliance issues, and then also focusing upon logistics sector, and then high speed and reliable linking of industrial parks and ports. So equally contract enforcement, like things like contract enforcement is necessary, recourse available to firms in case of violations, length of settlement periods and legal processes extra need to be considered. So this is all about your today's question. So you can see that nearly 22 minutes have been consumed in the in discussing this question. So you can we have basically provided you a comprehensive understanding of the topic, so you can get the idea of how to approach a particular answer. So also then friends, if in case you are interested to join our test series, that is Daily Mains Answer Writing Initiative, then you can use these link this link to join our test series. The link will also be provided in the description box. So in this initiative, we daily provide you 5 questions, out of which 3 are based from your current topic and 2 are based from your static topic. So we not just only provide you questions, but also we evaluate your answers, as well as we provide you comprehensive feedback. So also reference material is also shared for various various questions, all the questions. For example, in this video you have seen the reference source of only one question, and you can see that how comprehensive it is, and it helps in improving your answer writing skills and completing your one complete whole topic in a comprehensive manner. And it is also least costly, and you can join on a monthly basis as well. So this is the link that is shown on your screen, and this link will also be provided in the description box by which you can join. And this is our website, that is www.achieveies.co.in, and this is a YouTube channel. Do ensure that you subscribe to this channel. And also if you have any queries, if you have any doubt, you can mail us at achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at our number 89689207. 720. And lastly, we also have a Telegram channel on Telegram. Then you can also join this Telegram channel. More than 10,000 subscribers are there of this channel. So you can join and can get benefit and daily lectures on various topics. So this is all about today's video. If you liked it, do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day ahead.